Welcome to another FAR walkthrough video from SuperfastCPA. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over FAR, Area 1, and this is Section F. This is an application topic, calculate variances between budget and actual results. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into questions to learn the material. If you don't know much about our strategies, that is one of our main ideas, is jumping straight into the questions instead of watching hours of lectures or reading through an entire textbook. We have you focus on what you're going to be doing on test day, which is doing multiple choice questions and sims. So that's what you need to learn how to do, and you need to learn how to learn from multiple choice questions. So that is, again, one of our main strategies. Make sure you go check out our free one-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. We teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, and we will show you how to be effective and efficient with your studying so you don't waste any time. Also, just letting you know, we will only be going over 4 questions in today's video, and that's it. There's not going to be a pro member version of this video other than, you know, just the 4 questions being posted in the member forum as well. Normally, these videos are 5 questions long, and they have a 10-question version in the pro member forum so that pro members can get extra practice and extra learning. This is a small topic on the FAR exam. Most of this topic, variance analysis and things like that, have been moved to the bar exam instead of the FAR exam. So this is just a small topic in the FAR CPA blueprints. We're going to go over it, just 4 questions, just to make sure you have a small understanding of it. But normally, again, pro members have access to the full videos that we post in the members forum, which are typically double the amount of questions, so you can get more practice and more understanding. So if you like this and you like our other videos, make sure you go check out that SuperfastCPA webinar. And remember that if you become a pro member, you will have access to those full videos. With all that said, let's dive straight into the questions. All right, here we are at question 1. Something we always like to point out when we are doing these questions, especially calculation questions, is to read the last part of the question. That will give you context, because that's usually what the real question is. That's usually what is really being asked. So based on this information that is above, what is the net income variance, and is it favorable or unfavorable? So now we know we are looking for a net income variance. So now we read through this. ABC Corporation has prepared the following budget for the month of September. The budgeted revenue was $250,000. The budgeted operating expenses was $150,000. The budgeted net income was $100,000. And that makes sense, because the revenue was $250,000 less the expenses of $150,000, that's $100,000. So that makes sense that that was the budgeted net income. At the end of the month, the actual results for September are as follows. Actual revenue, $230,000. Actual operating expenses, $140,000. And actual net income, $90,000. So this is pretty straightforward, if I'm being honest. That's why it's such a small topic in the FAR exam, because it doesn't seem that they are testing you on the difficult parts of variance analysis. Really, they're just trying to have you figure out actual compared to budget. That seems to be what they're really focusing on for FAR. All of the complex stuff is in bar now. So really, this shouldn't be too difficult to figure out. If you don't know how to do it, that's okay. But again, I think if you think through this, you can do it. So pause the video if you want, do the calculation, and when you're ready, come back. We'll look at it together. All right, here we are. The answer is B. There's a $10,000 unfavorable variance. And again, that makes sense. Let's walk through this. The net income variance is calculated as the actual net income less the budgeted net income. And that's what you always want to do when you're comparing budget to actual. When it comes to these simple variances, you compare actual to budget. So you take actual less the budget, and that will tell you the variance. So the net income variance is $90,000 of actual net income that they received less the $100,000 that they had budgeted. So there's a $10,000 variance of net income, that means it's $10,000 less than they were expecting. And now, since this is income, if that's $10,000 less than they were expecting, that's not good. That is unfavorable. So in this case, it is a $10,000 unfavorable variance, because the net income was $10,000 lower than expected. Again, it's very straightforward. You just take the actual whatever you're comparing to the budgeted whatever you're comparing. And depending on if it's income or an expense, it'll be favorable or unfavorable. We'll talk about that a little bit more in the next questions. So let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question 2. As always, read the last part first. Using this information, calculate the material variance and identify if the variance is favorable or unfavorable. So now we're looking for a material variance. So let's go ahead and read the actual information. XYZ Manufacturing Company produces electronic components. The standard quantity of materials expected for production in August was 5,000 pounds at a standard price of $8 per pound. However, the actual quantity of materials used was 5,200 pounds and the actual price paid was $9 per pound. So again, what is the material variance here, as in how much money variance was there for these materials? Was it favorable? Was it unfavorable? It's not too difficult because we're just taking a simple approach for this topic. If you have an idea of how to do it, pause the video and do the calculation. If not, again, let's go to the answer to learn how it works. All right, here we are. The answer is B, $6,800 unfavorable variance. So let's walk through this. The formula for material variance is the actual quantity used multiplied by the actual price. So that's one number right there, less the standard quantity expected multiplied by the standard price. And that's one number. So you take the actual quantity price less the standard quantity price, and that gives you the material variance in this case. So 5,200 pounds multiplied by $9 per pound, that is the actual that was paid, and that's $46,800. And then there's the 5,000 pounds multiplied by the $8, and that was the budgeted pounds and the budgeted dollars, and that was $40,000. So the material variance was $6,800 because they spent $6,800 more than they were expecting. Now, if you ever studied BEC, or you've studied BAR, or you studied FAR before 2024, there is, of course, more to variance analysis than just this small actual to budget. There's a whole bunch of different things like volume analysis and things like that. It can get kind of complicated. Again, that is specifically on BAR now. So we are only focusing for this FAR CPA blueprint topic on actual to budget. That's all we're thinking about. So the actual was $46,800. The budgeted was $40,000. And that's all we're comparing. So there was a $6,000 unfavorable because in this case, it's an expense. So if you spent $6,800 more than you were expecting, that's an unfavorable variance. So again, since the variance is a positive amount, because there's $6,800 positive, meaning the actual cost is higher than the standard, it's unfavorable. Let's go to the next question to learn a little bit more about this. All right, here we are at question 3. Using this information, calculate the sales variance and identify if it is favorable or unfavorable. Let's go through this. The sales budget for the third quarter was, they were budgeting units to be sold, 13,500 units, and they were budgeting that each of these would be sold for $52. At the end of the quarter, the actual results were that they sold 15,000 units instead of 13,500, and they sold them for $50 instead of $52. So what is the sales variance here? Again, we're not doing a super big deep dive. Think of this simply. Pause the video if you need to, do the calculation, and when you're ready, come back, we'll look at it together. All right, here we are. The answer is B, $48,000 favorable. That is the favorable variance. So let's talk about this. The sales variance. Again, it's pretty straightforward when we're just talking about it in this simple fashion. Actual units sold multiplied by the actual price. So that's the actual money that they received, less the budgeted units sold multiplied by the budgeted price, or the budgeted amount that they were thinking they were going to receive. Or, of course, you could just take the actual sales less the budgeted sales. Like if you're looking at an income statement and at the top they have the sales, like the revenue, and there's the budgeted sales or revenue, you can just take the actual sales less the budgeted sales. But in this case, we had to figure out the actual sales amount and the actual budgeted amount. Anyway, we go down here, 15,000 multiplied by $50. That gives you $750,000 of sales. That was the actual sales. And then the budgeted was 13,500 units multiplied by $52 per unit, or 702,000 budgeted sales. So the actual was 750,000 less the budgeted 702,000. That gives you a $48,000 favorable variance. And again, the reason that this is favorable is because when it comes to income or revenue, if you received more income or more revenue for the actual compared to the budget, that's a good thing. That's favorable. Contrast that, of course, with the expenses. If your expenses were higher than you were budgeting, that's not good. That's unfavorable because you spent more money than you were expecting. So just remember that favorable and unfavorable does not always mean more is good, less is bad. Just make sure you remember that. Now, again, this is pretty simple. We're not doing anything other than this. So let's go to the last question for this video. All right, here we are at question 4. Again, this is the last question for this video. Based on this information, which of the following is the correct classification of favorable, or F, and unfavorable, or U, variances? So we need to look at all of these budgeted amounts and actual amounts and see which ones are favorable variances or unfavorable variances. We don't even need to necessarily know the amounts. We just need to know whether they're favorable or unfavorable. Of course, you'll need to know the amounts in your head to figure that out. But anyway, let's read through this. XYZ Services prepared the following budget for the month of October. And so again, this is the budget. Budgeted revenues, $100,000. Budgeted salaries expense, $30,000. Budgeted rental expense, $15,000. Budgeted utilities expense, $5,000. At the end of October, the actual results were actual revenue, $95,000. Salaries, $28,000. Rent expense, $17,000. And utilities, $4,500. So this is the actual, this is the budgeted. So we need to compare the budgeted revenue to the actual revenue, salaries to the budgeted salaries to the actual salaries, and so on, and figure out which of these is favorable and unfavorable. Again, very simple. We've talked about it enough in this video, I think, for you to do that. So pause the video, think through each of these, and come back when you're ready, and we'll look at the answer together. All right, here we are at the answer. A, the favorable variances would be the salaries and the utilities, and the unfavorable variances would be the revenue and the rent. So let's walk through this. So let's go to the favorable variances first. So favorable was salaries. So let's go to salaries. The actual salaries expense was $28,000, which is lower than the budgeted amount of $30,000, resulting in a $2,000 favorable variance, as spending less than budgeted is favorable. And then let's look at utilities. The actual utilities expense was $4,500, which is lower than the budgeted amount of $5,000, resulting in a $500 favorable variance. And again, because they're spending less than they were expecting, so that's good, that's favorable. Now let's go to the unfavorable variances. The revenue, the actual revenue was $95,000, which is lower than the budgeted revenue of $100,000, resulting in a $5,000 unfavorable variance, as lower than expected income is considered unfavorable. So again, contrast that to the salaries expense. The salaries expense was lower than budgeted. The revenue was lower than budgeted. But because it's revenue or expenses, if your revenue is less than you were expecting, that's not good, that's unfavorable. Whereas if you're spending less money for the expenses than you budgeted, that's good, that's favorable. So again, remember, favorable does not always mean that the actual was higher than the budgeted. It just depends on if it's revenue or an expense. Same with unfavorable. Unfavorable does not always mean that the budgeted was higher than the actual. It depends on if it's a revenue or an expense. So remember that. Now let's talk about rent. Last of all, the rent expense was unfavorable because it was $17,000, which is higher than the budgeted $15,000. So $2,000 unfavorable variance because, again, they spent $2,000 more than they were budgeting. And with that, we've covered pretty much anything you would need to know for the CPA exam when it comes to FAR. A lot of this is going to be way more expanded and way more in-depth if you take the bar exam. You'll have to do some variance analysis stuff there. But as for FAR, you don't need to do too much more than this because we're going to start talking about other things in FAR Area 2 now. Before we go any further, before we finish the video, let's look at the pillar topics for this video. Now, just a reminder, the idea behind pillar topics is as you're going through the questions to learn the material, you will notice the things that keep popping up, the things that they are trying to teach you. You will see multiple questions about one calculation or about one topic, and you know that it's important because, again, the review course is showing you a whole bunch of questions about it. So you take your learning, your understanding, and you summarize it in your own words as a pillar topic, and you're doing this each day as you're going through the questions to learn the material so that you are constantly reaffirming and taking a second to evaluate what is most important from what you're learning from the questions. Let's go to the pillar topics for this video. All right, here we are at the pillar topics. First off, variance measures the difference between budgeted results and actual results. That's about as far as you need to go for the FAR CPA exam now. It helps identify whether performance is better or worse than expected. Favorable variance, as a reminder, this occurs when actual results are better than budgeted. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're higher than budgeted. It means that they're better than budgeted. So what does that mean? Again, that could mean that your revenues are higher or that your expenses are lower than you were budgeting for. So that would be a favorable variance. Unfavorable variance is the opposite. This occurs when actual results are worse, not lower, worse than budgeted expectations. So that would be a lower revenue or higher expenses. So again, just remember, favorable does not always mean higher than budget. Unfavorable does not always mean lower than budgeted. So that's kind of the one point that I wanted to make sure was clear from this video. And again, this is going to be a topic that is much bigger on the bar exam. So this is about as far as you need to go for the FAR CPA exam when it comes to this variance type analysis for budget and actual. And with that, we've gone over everything. Before you go, make sure you check out our free 1-hour webinar training on superfastcpa.com. Again, it's only 1 hour. It is free, and we will teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam such as, again, going to the questions first, making sure you have daily review built into your studying, and things like that. Make sure you go check it out because we will teach you the rest of the key ingredients. And also, just remember, typically these videos are around 5 questions, and there's a pro member version of most of the videos in the pro member forum of superfastcpa.com, where there is double the questions so that the pro members can get more explanation and especially more practice. So if you like this and you like our other videos, just remember that you can become a pro member and get access to our full walkthrough videos on our pro member forum. But in today's video, we only went over 4 questions because, again, this is a pretty small topic on the FAR exam. One more thing, make sure you check out the CPA Exam Experience podcast from Superfast CPA. That is a fantastic podcast. It is also free, and we talk with tons of people. I think we have over 150 episodes now where we talk to people who have had success stories going from failing over and over again to passing their CPA exams by purchasing Superfast CPA. So make sure you check that out as well. Again, the CPA Exam Experience podcast from Superfast CPA. If you liked the video, make sure to like it and leave a comment. I hope this was all helpful, and I will see you in the next video.